Hello everyone, in this video I will explain how we can install Java 21 without homebrew. If you want to install Java 21 using homebrew, then you can watch the another video. I have uploaded a separate video. So in this video we will install Java 21 using the DMG file which is available on the Oracle's official website. So let's start that. So first I'll check on the terminal whether any Java version is installed or not in my system. So I'll go to the terminal first. Then if I search here Java version, then you can see you will get something like this error, which means Java is not installed in my system. So I'll open this Oracle's official website link. You can reach to this link by just searching on Google Java 21 installed. So let me show you that as well. So if I just type Java 21 download and then Oracle, then click on this link, so you will reach the same link. Okay, so if I go to this particular link, so you can see JDK 17 is there and the 21 is there, because 21 has recently been released in the September month, so that's why it is coming here. And the 17 is the LTS version, that's why it is coming. And I am not logged in into this, so the login is not required to install these two versions. So I'll go to the macOS option here. Then there are two options, DMG, one is the ARM64. So if your system is silicon chip based Mac system, so then you will have to go with this option. And if your system is Intel based system, then you will have to go with this DMG installer. The further process is same for both of the options. Since my system is silicon based, so I'll go with this. So I'll just click on this particular link. I'll click save so that the downloading will start. And as you can see, the login is not required to download this particular DMG file. So once the DMG file will be downloaded, we'll start the installation. So it is downloaded. So I'll just click on this. Then this PKG file will be shown up to you as well. So I'll just double click on this. This pop-up will come up now. Then I'll click on continue. Then I'll click on install. So this much space it will take on your computer. So it is recommended to have this much space or some extra space as well. So I'll click on install now. So it will ask me the password for this current system. I'll click on install software. Then it might take couple of minutes. Installation is succeeded. I'll close this now. Then it is asking me whether I want to keep this particular JDK installer or not. So for now I'll keep this. Then I'll close this. I'll go to the terminal now. Let's check again what is the Java version now. So the 21 is there, so it means it is installed. There is one more thing. If we check the variable value of Java home, then it is coming empty. So for some of the programs it is required to be set, so we'll set this particular value with the path where the JDK is installed. So let's go to that particular location where the JDK is installed. So I'll go to the library, then Java, then Java virtual machine, then if I do ls here, then you can see this is the folder here the JDK is installed. So if I go to this particular location, then if I do ls, then you can see contents is there. So I'll go to this contents folder, then if I do ls again, so you can see there is home folder. So here this is the Java home folder. So inside that all the binaries and the required files are present. So we need to set this particular path in the Java home variable. So for that, first I'll go to this home folder as well, and I'll just do pwd. So this path we need to set to this particular variable. For permanently set this particular value, we will edit this in the ZRC file or the bashrc. So if you are using the Catalina or the higher version of Catalina, then there would be ZRC. If you are using lower version than Catalina, then there will be the bashrc. So you can check that in the home folder as well. Okay, so I will list down all the hidden files as well. So as you can see, for me it is ZSH, not the bash. So here I am interested in this ZSHRC file. So I'll open this particular file. So let me clear the screen first. And I'll do the pwd. And I will use the VI editor. And I will open this particular file. Let me first copy this particular path also. So here I need to press I first, so that the it will be the insert mode. So as you can see, now I have pressed I and it has moved to the insert mode. Now I can write anything into this particular file. So I'll write java underscore home equal to, and that path which I have copied. So this was the path for the home folder. Now I will press the escape button. Now the colon and W and Q, which is write and then quit. Now I have to enter. Now I will have to source this particular file. I will source this. Now if I again check the value for Java home variable, now you can see this particular path is set. This way the Java 21 is installed in your system as well. If you face any issue, you can write it down in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video, and please subscribe the channel.